DMs, love. CammieWammie couldn't have did it without Tola. What's poppin', Cash Side Gang? It's your back, CammieWammie, aka Miss Sadie. And I'm back today with another motherfreaking banger for y'all niggas. Yeah. So basically, in today's vlog, or in today's video, I'm gonna be doing a self-care vlog. It's basically like a kind of all my appointments with me, but instead it's gonna be a twist to it. I'm gonna add some more to it. Basically, y'all gonna like see me getting my hair done and stuff, but then you're gonna see me doing other forms of self-care, because I really hate that like society has like created this bubble of what self-care is, like, oh, get your hair done, get your nails done, duh, 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 get your lashes done type shit. No, self-care can be anything, because self-care is literally showing that you care about yourself. Like, you could be hungry, and if you get up and fix yourself something to eat, that's self-care, because somebody who didn't care about themselves would just starve type shit. So yeah, I'm not gonna, well, of course I probably might show myself eating, but that's not like what I'm saying. What I'm saying is I'm gonna be doing more forms of self-care. So this is gonna be like me doing like little face masks, journaling, going out with my friends, you know what I'm saying, living life. Basically, it's a nice little vlog. That's what it is. But the main theme of it is self-care, and I'm gonna make sure that I reinforce that throughout the video and like explain my examples of the self-care that I show in these videos. And I hope that this inspires you to get your butt up, you know what I'm saying. If your hair ain't done, come book me, what are you doing, or book your local hairstylist, get your hair done. If you want your lashes done, get your lashes done, get your nails done, period, because you are a bad and you need to get up and show that you care about yourself, period. But yeah, that's like everything I wanted to say. I already got my nails done. I went to Motu to get my nails done, my girl Mutariah, and they look good. She's a beginner, y'all, too. So for a beginner, this is like amazing. Yeah. But basically, I got like a whole lot of other stuff going on. Okay, so Monday I have my lash appointment, so I'm gonna be getting my lashes done. Saturday I have my hair appointment, so I'm gonna be taking my sewing out, and I'm gonna be getting some boho knotless again, but they're gonna be small. And this time I'm actually using human hair, because y'all be trim, but I got some leftover bundles. I could have been using human hair, but yeah, I'm about to go get my hair done by Tola. I'm about to go get my lashes done. I'm going to a lash tech for the first time on Monday, guys. I don't go to lash techs to get my lashes done, because like, I had a bad experience with the first girl that I tried to book with, and I just started doing my lashes from there ever since. But now I'm going to, you know, get them done. So we're going to see how that goes. And then this weekend, oh, I thought my hair was, it is, but whatever. And then this weekend, and I don't have a bobbin, y'all. It's literally a sewing. The claw clip is falling. But yeah. This weekend, I'm going to be going to an Airbnb party too, so I'm probably going to vlog that. And I have to go shopping. I have to go to Target and get like some hygiene stuff, because I'm low on everything. So, y'all just going to see a whole lot. I just wanted to explain the video and give my personal take on self-care. Self-care can be anything, girl. You don't have to get your hair done. You could do your own hair, okay? As long as you care, as long as you look like somebody care about you, i.e. yourself, you good, son. And yeah, so I'm going to see y'all probably when I'm getting my lashes done, which be Monday. And right now, it is currently December 31st, 2022. So I'm gonna see y'all next year. Hey, y'all. Y'all, you forgot in my name. This is my favorite. Yeah. You gon', you know how you wanna do your leggings and stuff?
I don't even know. And I tried to use Canva, but it was so hard.
I couldn't even
use Canva. You wanna be in it?
It's fine.
Okay. Hey y'all. So I'm finna get my lashes done. I'm gonna put her page on here. But yeah.
The shit that I be on, it be honest. Trust the bitch, see flames if it's coming. A nigga on me and he want it. And I'm with the shit, slim thick, early 20s. I seen the shit I see, but no responding. Bitch, spell check, you speak Ebonic. Better know the book you're reading. I swear these bitches be slow. This is shit that bitches be hating on. Cause they know if I let them hit it, that nigga is wrong.
Hey y'all, so it's later and I did somebody here and stuff like that. These are my lashes, y'all. They cute and she was cool and stuff like that. Like, I fuck with her, but like $100. And I get my hair done on Saturday. I'm pretty sure I already said that. And we not going to DeFi tonight because we were supposed to go, but then, like, the girl who hair I was doing, she didn't want to come earlier, so we just didn't end up going. But I'm pretty sure we're going to go somewhere later this week, so it don't even matter. Yeah, I'm finna edit now, though, y'all. Okay, how many you want?
Hey, this is the girl who did my hair. I'm gonna put her Instagram. This is like the only girl I go to for my braids. If I'm not doing my braids, it's her. Yeah, we finna get busy with this hair. Got some TV on.
I look crazy. No, you don't. Y'all, this is how all hairstyles look. If you a girl, you know.
Yeah, you know.
Okay. Well, my mom just told me that we're gonna go see Avatar later. But let me guys give you guys my hair page so you guys can go book with me. First of all, y'all follow my actual Instagram because my Instagram had deleted my page. And I only got like 400 followers, so that's not cool. But y'all follow my hair page and make sure y'all book with me too. Hold on. Yeah, y'all follow me. And yeah. And yeah, I'm a little tired, y'all, but we gonna finish this last section off. There she go, y'all. And yeah.
Push your teeth, push your tongue to weed. Need a brand new weed. Kill my dog, pussy nigga. Please, I go keep yelling weed. He don't go. Why you telling me to let a nigga see? Honestly, I'm not feeling you, but you not feeling me. Keep it cheap. Welcome at the age, just let that nigga be. TLC, no, I'm finna creep my phone on D&D. Let my soul, why that did to beat up, why that did to sleep. You ain't peep, but you know you beat to me, he beat his me.
I need mean, cheese. I tell that nigga, tell that nigga, fuck, he make up, yeah, you can't be that all right here.
I'm so like stiff when I first get my hair done because like, you know. Y'all, my forehead is never given when I first get my hair done. y'all see it?
I'm
bullying you, y'all. Don't talk about it. Okay, y'all. So this is the final. Y'all already know who did it. Done by the best out here. Okay, y'all, so I just got my hair done. Hopefully her house not in the background, but I just got my hair done and I love her. Like, that is really my friend, y'all. It's crazy how like clients turn into friends and stuff like that. Like, I really, really mess with her. But I'm about to get in the car. Maybe I was kind of lied on to talk to y'all in the car. I'm probably gonna make TikTok.
Y'all, my phone just died. Don't talk about my forehead either. But I'm back at home, y'all. I look so freaking good, and the truth is CammieWammie couldn't have did it without Tola. Sure, whatever that TikTok said. Cuz yeah, like, really though, like, if you live around here, which half of y'all do, cuz I don't have a big subscriber count and everybody that subscribed to me know me personally, which means y'all live around here. If you live around here, why the heck you ain't boo with Tola? Like, Tola's hair corner. Why you ain't booked with Tola? Like, I'm on a roll, y'all. So, honestly, I think the last time I talked to y'all was today. Y'all, I don't remember. I don't remember the last time I talked to y'all. But it's January 15th. And it's at oh God! Oh, you lying? I mean, I don't do nothing with my life, y'all. It's 11 o'clock. Y'all need to get my life together. But that's what we're here for. So basically, I'm really trying to get good content for my videos. So I decided, like, let's do a face mask chit chat portion of the video, because why not? So, basically, I'm gonna be doing the asset clay mask, which you mean apple cider vinegar. I put together a list of questions that, like, I wanted to answer in this video. And I was gonna ask Instagram to ask me some questions, which I actually did. But, like, you know, like, talking to Instagram be like talking to a brick wall, so you know I ain't get. I got responses, but, like, it was planned. I'm not trying to do all that, babe. I'm trying to be serious. This is CammieWammie. Fuck is you talking about? Anyways, yeah, so I got my little bowl and my brush and my mixing thing. I really could use either one of these, but I just wanted to be extra. I'm about to clean up my bowl. This is clean, but it's not that clean. So, hey, demand. Okay, it is a little bit watery, but that's okay. Because the thicker you make it, the harder it's going to peel off. So, the first question is, what are your goals in 2023 YouTube-wise? So, basically, like, my goals, I feel like, are to start being consistent personally, because like that's one thing that I know like I really be struggling with is like consistency. Like, I be kind of struggling with consistency real bad, because it's just like, for one, I feel like I'm always, and this is something to do like more personally with me than other people, but I'm always like questioning myself. Like, I realize that I'm not really sure like of myself. And so like that's also another thing I need to get rid of, because like look at what it's affecting. Because now I be like, well, do you even want to do YouTube? Because what if you don't blow up? Like, I'm always doubting myself and stuff like that. I don't fuck with that. So yeah, that's like being consistent. I want to be able to post 2 videos a week, because I can do it, y'all. And honestly, I'm not trying to start like posting 2 videos a week all that or nothing, but I'm definitely gonna start soon. Like right now, 1 video is fine with me. 1 video a week, that's fine with me, because girl, I got more than enough time. But also like I said, I'll be stuck. Also, another reason like I don't be consistent is because I be stuck between like living in the moment and then like living for the cameras type shit. And I think another goal of mine, which this has nothing to do with me, but I know I can make it happen, I want to reach 10k before December. I know I can do it, y'all. I've seen other people do it. I can do it, bro. I've seen people gain thousands of followers just off posting like one trendy video. You know what I'm saying? So I know for sure I can do it. So yeah, those are my goals for 2023, or two of them. I probably have more. The next question is, what are different ways to perform self-care? Y'all see how I tried like to do questions that was like related to this video? Yeah. So like, I feel like in the intro of this video, I said it, I was like, self-care is literally anything. If you feed yourself, if you take a bath, like, that's literally all self-care. And that's true. But I will tell y'all some other, like, popular ways to perform self-care. I want to talk about journaling. Excuse me. I don't journal as consistently, but I can say this. It was a point in time where I was journaling consistently, and I will say, like, you will never need nobody to vent to again. Like, you, is a diary, whatever the fuck you want to call it. Yes. And I feel like my journal is like literally for everything, y'all. Like, my journal isn't just for like to like write in when I'm sad. My journal is also to write in when I'm like out of it, when I'm depressed, shadow work, when I'm happy, manifestations, affirmations, gratitude. Like, my journal is for everything. And I feel like, yeah, like that's something y'all should start. If you want to start self-care, like if you want to start prioritizing yourself, but like you don't necessarily know how to besides like keeping up with your looks, if you want to start prioritizing yourself spiritually, a journal. That's all I'm gonna say. Like, y'all, I manifest my life away in that journal, and I thank God, and I write letters to remind me to be grateful for everything I have in life, even when things aren't going my way. And like, if you want to solve problems that you have within yourself, baby, shadow work. Like, shadow work is basically bringing out the emotions that growing up we're taught not to bring out. So like jealousy, what I'm about to say is about to sound really crazy, but jealousy is actually not a bad thing at all. Like, jealousy is the cousin to inspiration. Like, inspiration is technically looking at somebody else and being like, oh, she did that, and I could do something like that too. Like, I can do it too. It's looking at it and like knowing that you can do it for yourself. Inspiration is looking at somebody else's results and being like, how can I make this for myself? You know, that's the question that usually comes out of inspiration. Jealousy is looking at another person and being like, damn, she did that. Why she get to have all of this and I don't? You know what I'm saying? You're not asking how you can make that way for yourself, but you hating. You know what I'm saying? Like, and that's just like what people naturally result to, I guess. You know, like, that's what the human mind just goes to, or some people. And I feel like that would be a question for shadow work. Like, why do I always get jealous? why do I always ask why blah 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 has this instead of how can I have this, you know? And I think a way to answer that question, which it might not be your answer, but like if that was me, I could say something like, because I don't look at myself as a main character or something like that. You know what I'm saying? Like, it'd be a lot of reasons why people be the way that they be. And if you know that you're a horrible, well, not a horrible person, but if you know that you flaw, that's literally the way to like get to the bottom of that. Like, that's gonna get you to the root of childhood trauma type shit. And like, I feel like, I don't know, like shadow work though, it's a journey. Because I will say, like, it starts with having to be real with yourself. If you're delusional about yourself, if you can't keep it a brick with yourself, you will never get nowhere doing shadow work. Because the first way to fix a problem is to recognize the shit. You know what I'm saying? Y'all, my camera's literally gonna die. I'm done putting this on now. Okay, y'all. My camera died, but I'm done putting on a face mask. And I let mine sit for like 5 minutes, y'all, and it's 11:19, so at 11:24, I will be taking this off y'all. And I'm gonna show y'all how I take mine off without making a mess. But you, it's best to leave it in there for like 15 minutes, but I have sensitive skin, so I'm not going for that. Anyway, back to what I was saying about inspiration and like shadow work and stuff. Yeah, like, the first way to fix the problem is to recognize it. If you're gonna be delusional with yourself, if you're gonna tell yourself like, I don't get jealous when I see this, or if you're gonna tell yourself, and I see why people do it, because like I said, from like the moment that we're first born, it's, you're not supposed to be jealous of them. You know what I'm saying? Like, they tell you you're not supposed to be a way, but they're not helping you on how to be a different way from that. You know what I'm saying? So I get it, but like, I'm telling you now, like, you need to own up to that shit, take accountability. So when you get to that shadow work, you get to the bottom of it. And y'all, it'd be a long journey. It's gotta be something you gotta be like consistent with, like every day. And I'm real, like I ain't been being consistent with mine, but I know this is something like that you need to do. You gotta be consistent with it every day. You know what I'm saying? Some days you might cry while you writing type shit, but like, it is what it is. You're gonna come out a better person anyway, so it don't matter. Yeah, that's like one way you can perform shadow work. I mean, one way you can perform self-care. I feel like another big way that like we don't talk about in performing self-care is alone time. Like, I feel like you should spend time with yourself, y'all, because you're gonna end up like a motherfucker like me. And let me tell y'all, I am like so codependent now. Like, I'm getting back used to being with myself, but like probably like 2-3 weeks ago, baby, I had to be on the phone with somebody, especially because I had a boyfriend. I had to be on the phone with somebody. Or I had to be on the phone with my best friend, my boyfriend, or my ex. Like, I had to be on the phone with somebody. Because, like, I was so used to just always being on the phone. And that's when, like, I feel like I'm kind of going through a spiritual awakening. So that's when, like, everybody who wasn't for me just started leaving. And that just happened to be, like, a big part of, like, the people that I hang out with on a daily. So once I had nobody to talk to, and like, I'm not about to chase nobody. That's one thing about it too, bitch. For sure, like, I'm codependent. But baby, if I call that phone twice and you don't answer, you're never going to call on me again. Like, fuck. So, you know, like, once I was calling folks and I wasn't answering, it just left me with myself. So, I just, you know what I'm saying? And now, like, people still be calling me and stuff. But I really, like, sometimes I just watch the phone. And sometimes I decline. Sometimes I tell them I want to talk. Because, like, once I realized I was codependent, I was like, oh no, nah, baby, this ain't it, because I don't want to feel like I need to be around somebody. And you shouldn't feel like that either. And like, if that's one of your, that's one of the symptoms, like, if you always gotta be on the phone with somebody, if you always gotta be talking to somebody, girl, you got a problem and you need to get rid of it. Because like, yeah, so that's why I said, like, spending a long time with yourself, what do you like to do? That's not a question you can ask too many people. Like, you can't ask too many people, like, what do you like to do on your own? Like, without your friends, without your mom, without your dad, without your sister, without anybody. What do you personally like to do? You can't ask somebody that question. Half of the people that you ask are not gonna have a direct answer, because they don't spend enough time with themselves to even know that. So, yeah, like, I figure out stuff I like all the time. But, what's the name? Spending time with myself. I figure out not only do I figure out like what I like to do, girl, I come up with new ideas for content. I come up with new ideas for stuff outside of content. I come up with new hustles, baby. Like I come up, yeah, I listen to music. Like I have a good time by myself, and I just needed like people to not answer the phone for me when I call them to understand it. So yeah, the next question I had was, the next question I had was, how am I mentally? So this is like, I'm gonna make this question like as simple as possible, because I feel like I'm real like complex, but I'm gonna make this question simple. And also like with that, y'all know I'm keeping real with y'all. That's the whole reason I'm doing YouTube, because I want to show y'all like I'm still a teenage girl. I still go through this, that, and the third. Like, everybody was once a teenager in their life. And you know how hard it is to be a teenager, from like FOMO to like just insecurities. Like, I still go through this stuff, but I'm on here to show y'all. Like, I go through this stuff, but I'm still that bitch. Period. Like, not even on nothing cocky, but I'm just saying, like, I go through this and I still am able to get up because I know, like, this not the end of the world type shit. And that's what I want to inspire y'all to. I want to be able to relate to y'all type shit. So, yeah, I was saying all that to say, like, y'all gonna know when I'm not okay. But I'm not going to, like, get into, like, every little detail. Like, it ain't gonna be, like, how I would write in my journal type shit. But anyways, finally, to answer the question, I told y'all I talk about it. To answer that question, I'm actually okay. Like, I feel like healing, growth, whatever you want to call it, it's not linear. It don't just go up, and just keep going up. It can go up, then down, then up, then down. Like, it can, you know what I'm saying? So, overall, it's like stocks. Like, overall, I'm going up. But I do have my little moments where I'm like, like, you know what I'm saying? So, yeah, I'm okay. I think that I'm just working right now mentally. Like, I'm working my mind. I'm exercising my mind to get rid of these mindsets, like these terrible mindsets. Like, when it comes to like things I'm insecure about, I can be real with myself and say, like, I never look at no female in no jealous way to where like I'm wishing bad on nobody else. That would never be a part of my character. But it is time where I do look at another female and I be like, well, damn, she bad. And she got something that I don't have. And like, I start feeling like pitiful for myself. That's one of my problems, I will be honest with. And like, I'm just training myself not to do that. Like, okay, you know what I'm saying? You don't have that, but you can work to get that if you really wanted it. Or, you know what I'm saying? Like, you're perfect the way you are. Like, you know what I'm saying? I'm telling myself stuff like that. So, yeah. I'm trying to think, y'all. Yeah, that's it really. I'm just in a lab type shit. That's what I like to call that. I be in my mode, like I'm in the lab. I'm not really like, you know what I'm saying? Yeah. The next question is, what areas of life do you prioritize? Where an aspect, what's first, what's last? So, this is actually a question that get my gears kind of like, now I gotta actually think, because I kind of just live on a day-to-day basis. I don't really think. So, I definitely prioritize my me time a lot. Like, y'all, I'm keeping it so above right now. Like, I talk to myself all the time. Like, not even when I'm talking to the camera, I just did I talk to myself. Every time I want to talk to myself, every time I want to listen to music. Like, those are my favorite things to do. So, and this is just me being honest. That's like the first thing on my list, because I will, like, get the biggest attitude with people if I'm having had my time to myself. So yeah. Y'all, this shit's starting to itch. I'm about to take this shit off. Anyways, and it's all falling off of me. Yeah, it's time to take this off. Anyways, we got one more question, y'all. First, I prioritize like myself, me time. I think the second thing that I prioritize is like, really, if I'm being 100%,
being productive. I don't know why, but like it just helped me get out of my head. Like, I know I just said I like to think a lot and like talk to myself a lot, but then it gets to a point where I be too deep in, like I be in my head for real. So like when that shit happened, it's just, I feel like I always gotta be doing something. If I'm just laying down in bed, I be like, you could be doing, I'm sorry y'all, this shit gotta come off. Okay, but like if I'm laying down in the bed and I'm watching TV or something, it's always in the back of my mind like, you could be doing something better right now. You could be doing something beneficial to like your future type shit. So like being productive is like probably the second thing I prioritize. The third thing is for sure like spending time with my folks. I feel like, honestly, I don't spend enough time with them, if I'm being real. And I could, it's just like, I don't know y'all, I just get in that mode where I ain't trying to be around folks. I ain't even bothered. But like, everybody gotta leave someday, and I would hate for it to that day, God forbid, I would hate for that day to be tomorrow, and then I'll be left weeping, moping, you know what I'm saying? Because I already learned that lesson the first time, and now I really actually need to apply it before it, like, and like I said, God forbid, but anything can happen. So yeah, I definitely need to spend more time with my family, because I think losing my grandma made me realize it. Like, I never, of course, like, everybody gonna have a relationship with their grandma, but it's like 15 of us. Like, she had like 15 grandkids. You get what I'm saying? Like, she loved us all equally, but I didn't spend enough time with her to the point where, like, you know, and that shit. And when she died, I definitely felt bad, because I know there was moments in my life where I wanted to get to know more about her. Moral of that story, girl, spend time with your mom. If you gotta pause this video and go call your dad or whatever the fuck, you do that. Cause when they leave, you stuck with nothing but memories of them. So make as many as you can. So, yeah. What question was I even trying to answer? Oh, what do I prioritize? And then like everything after that, like literally everything just comes in a random order on a random day. Like Tuesday, I might be in my schoolwork more than I'm getting to talking to like a nigga or something. The next day, like, you know what I'm saying? Like, and not to say that I don't prioritize my schoolwork, because baby, I don't have no choice but to get good grades. So that's out the window. But like, you see what I'm saying? Work. It's, I won't say it's necessarily easy, but at the end of the day, I'm always trying a way to get it done before the deadline. So it don't matter. Yeah. That's how I feel. The last question is, and I'm gonna change the tense to this, how would you manage your time? Because the question was, how do you manage your time? But I say, how would you? Because it's how I wish I could manage my time. It's all common sense, y'all. It's all about not procrastinating, being organized, and using your brain, to be honest. Because I'm a very busy person, y'all. I'm an actor slash model. I'm a hairstylist, YouTuber, cheerleader, and I have school. Plus, I'm also just like a regular teenager that just be wanna go out with my friends. So, how does this work? Boom. I feel like you need a game plan. Like, you don't know when you're getting booked, but you don't ever know when you're getting booked as a hairstylist. But what you can control is when you get booked. And like, y'all, this shit itch. Y'all know y'all like, girl, if you don't take the face mask off, I want to finish it though. But yeah, like what you can control is when you get booked. And so if I knew that me and my friend, we trying to hang out, girl, I be trying to get money by all means, you know what I'm saying? But like at the same time, you don't gotta slave yourself for that shit. I let the money come to me. So I might like cancel a day, or like the hours that I know me and my friend are gonna be out, I'll take that day off the site or them hours, so I can't nobody book that. So boom, that's our time. And I'm not just booking that time, I'm also booking the time for me to get ready and stuff, like, you know? So like, yeah, like staying organized, not procrastinating. Y'all, I promise you, if you just get up and do shit when it's supposed to be done, you get so much farther in life. Like, honestly, and I be telling myself that shit in school, I be like, damn, I don't feel like doing this. But I be like, just do it, because you're gonna be so happy that you did it. So then, like, when later come, you ain't gotta be scrambling to do it. Because I know we've all been in that situation, and I've been in that situation too many times, so I know, like, so I'll be like, just do it now so you don't be tripping out. And yeah, so like, not procrastinating, and I just using your head. Like, if you know you got something to do, or you know, like, you probably have something to do, ask. You know what I'm saying? Ask about this shit. Or, you know what I'm saying? Don't, like, just make plans. Like, oh, well, I don't know if my girl is going to book. Like, say, for instance, if somebody booked me, but they don't send a deposit, technically, your appointment is not secure. And I could, like, cancel it any time. Because as sad as it has to be, I got to be strict about deposits now, y'all. But just because, you know, I can cancel her appointment doesn't mean I am. Because she could still pay full price, you know what I'm saying? But I will say this, though. What I'm not going to do is be like, oh, she ain't sent her deposit, so technically her appointment is canceled. So I'm just going to go out Saturday instead. Because then what happens when you make plans with your friends, and right after that, your client sent her deposit. You know what I'm saying? Like, be smart about this shit. So, yeah. I'm about to take this off though, y'all. I really just wanted to answer those questions because I feel like I don't ever, like, I don't know, I be talking to y'all. I do be talking y'all head off, but like, it don't be, And I hope y'all listen because I really just be a game and put y'all down. I'm about to get a rag though. I'm about to show y'all how I take my shit off. Hey y'all, so it's Friday, it's January 20th, and it's 8 p.m. on the dot, and I'm about to go to Target, because I told y'all I need to get stuff from Target, and I'm finally going. Like, I'll talk about that later, but yeah, so I'm gonna see y'all when I get to Target. Hey y'all, so I'm at Target right now. I hope y'all can hear me. I hope I'm talking loud enough. Y'all, this is my first time vlogging in a store. I'm scared. Look at my nails. I haven't talked to y'all in a long time. And I'm gonna talk about that when I get home, but let me just give y'all some quick updates. Baby, the lashes, gone. The nails, gone. The hands, ashy. Like, this is supposed to be a self-care video, and I look very uncared for. But that's okay. It's been like, I haven't talked to y'all in like a week. And let me tell y'all why. Basically, like, I was supposed to go to Target and get my toes done, and then I could finish this video. This video could have been up this week. But like, I don't know, like, it's just like, I was caught up in schoolwork, and then like, I was like, why is the lighting? Y'all, cause I hate when it be like bad lighting, cause like, please don't play with me. Is that why it's bad lighting? Come on, y'all. Y'all, I need these. They got, I like these, y'all. My Target just redid everything, and it looked real good. $5 for some cotton rounds? That shit is ridiculous. Hell no. Look at this. They got a freaking. Oh, what? Okay. Target, you did your big one, son. Cut through trim. Don't do it to him today. Different than every night. Not on my face, but like, it was like one day I would do one on my face. The next day I would do one. My lip mask, like, trying to get that like that. Duh. It's this girl on TikTok, and she does, I
wish they had the sensitive skin one. I mean the unscented bar. Whatever. Okay, but anyways, back to what I was saying. So this girl on TikTok, she do pH tests on like popular hygiene products, right? She did a pH test on the Dove sensitive skin, y'all. Why did that thing come out with like hella alkaline? Like this shit was so blue, y'all. I was like, what the fuck? And like I be using it so my damn sense. Oh hell no. So y'all know I had to switch. Lately, like, let me tell y'all, not only was the pH test, it came out to be alkaline soap. Girl, why is the Dove deodorant, spray-on deodorant, giving cysts? Like, these girls are getting cysts from using deodorant.
The shit that I be on, it be honest. Trust the bitch, see flames if it's coming. A nigga on me and he want it. And I'm with the shit slim thick early 20s. I seen the shit I see but no responding. Bitch, spell check and speak, eat panic.
Damn, why she just